Hello friends, welcome back to my channel. Today we are going to discuss graph theory. Simple graph, multigraph, weighted graph, paths and circuit, shortest path in weighted graph, Eulerian paths and circuit, Hamiltonian paths and circuit, planar graph, graph coloring, bipartite graph, trees and rooted trees, prefix codes, tree traversals, spanning trees and cut sets are the main points coming under graph theory. Graph theory started with Euler, who was asked to find an ice path across the seven Neusberg bridges. The Eulerian path should cross over each of the seven bridges exactly once. Then, what is graph theory? In the domain of mathematics and computer science, graph theory is the study of graphs that concern with the relationship among edges and vertices. Again, what's a graph? A graph is a pair of sets V, E, where V is the set of vertices and E is the set of edges connecting the pairs of vertices. V and E are assumed finite, that is V equal to N and E equal to M. In the given graph, V of G equal to V1, V2, etc., V5 and E of G equal to E1, E2, etc., E6. An edge EK equal to VI, VJ is incident with the vertices VI and VJ. The degree D of V of a vertex V is its number of incident edges. Basic theorem of graph theory. It is called handshaking theorem. The sum of the degrees of vertices of a graph G equal to VE equals 2 into E, which is equal to 2M. This is the trivial case. Degree of vertex. It is the number of vertices adjacent to a vertex V. In a simple graph with n number of vertices, the degree of any vertices is less than or equal to n minus 1 for all V belongs to G. Degree of vertex can be considered under two cases of graphs. They are undirected graph and directed graph. Degree of vertex in an undirected graph. An undirected graph has no directed edges. Consider the following example. Degree of A equal to 2, as there are two edges meeting at vertex A. Degree of B equal to 3, as there are three edges meeting at vertex B. Degree of vertex in a directed graph. In a directed graph, each vertex has an in degree and an out degree. Degree of vertex V is the number of edges which are coming into the vertex V. Out degree of a vertex V is the number of edges which are going out from the vertex V. Corollary. The number of vertices of odd degree is even, which is a trivial case. A complete graph Kn is a simple graph with all Cn2 equal to n into n minus 1 by 2 possible edges like the graph below for n equal to 2, 3, 4, 5, k2, k3, k4, k5. K regular graph is a simple graph with vertices of equal degree k. Graph terminologies. Graph is a collection of vertices and edges denoted by G of E, V, where V is the vertex set and E is the edge set. V greater than or equal to 1, E greater than or equal to 0. Null graph. Edgeless graph E equal to 0. A graph having no edges is called a null graph. In the above graph, there are three vertices named A, B and C, but there are no edges among them. Hence, it is a null graph. Magnitude of graph G characterized by number of vertices V called the order of G and the number of edges E, the size of G. Running time of graph theoretic algorithms measured in terms of order and size. Representation of graphs in memory. There are two ways we can represent a graph in memory. They are adjacency matrix representation and adjacency list representation. In adjacency matrix representation, two-dimensional array or matrix of order V cross V, say A, represent graph. That is, A equal to Aij is defined by Aij equal to 1 if ij belongs to E equal to 0 otherwise. Matrix symmetrical about upper left to lower right diagonal for undirected graph. Suitable representation for dense graph. Next one is adjacency list representation. Linked lists are used to represent the graph. Suitable representation for sparse graphs. Digraph. Directed graph. Edges are given direction. For an edge E equal to Vs, Vt, in a digraph, Vs is source node and Vt is terminal node. Undirected graph. No direction for edges. Degree of a vertex, number of edges incident on that vertex for undirected graph. Degree of a vertex equal to in degree plus out degree for directed graphs. In degree of a vertex means number of edges coming to that vertex. Out degree of a vertex is number of edges coming out from that vertex. A digraph is balanced if in degree equal to out degree for all vertices. Pendant or terminal vertex, a vertex whose degree is 1. Isolated or null vertex, a vertex whose degree is 0. Vertices of null graph. Graphs can be classified as follows. Graph category features. Pseudographs allow both self-loop and parallel edges, which is unrestricted. Multigraph allows parallel edges, restrict self-loop. Simple graphs restrict self-loop and parallel edges, most restricted. By default, graph theory focuses on simple graphs. Advanced graph theory deals with pseudo and multigraph. Self-loop, an edge whose terminal vertices are same. In a graph, if an edge is drawn from vertex to itself, it is called a self-loop. In this graph, V is a vertex for which it has an edge V, V forming a loop. Parallel or multiple edges. More than one edge all having the same terminal vertices. That is, multiple edges between a pair of vertices. In a graph, if a pair of vertices is connected by more than one edge, then those edges are called parallel edges. A graph having parallel edges is known as a multigraph. Simple graph. A graph with no loops and no parallel edges is called a simple graph. The maximum number of edges possible in a single graph with n vertices is nc2, where nc2 equal to n into n minus 1 by 2. The number of simple graphs possible with n vertices equal to 2 to the power of nc2, which is equal to 2 raised to n into n minus 1 by 2. The maximum number of edges with n equal to 3 vertices, nc2 equal to n into n minus 1 by 2, which is equal to 3 into 3 minus 1 by 2, which is equal to 6 by 2, equal to 3 edges. The maximum number of simple graph with n equal to 3 vertices, 2 raised to nc2 equal to 2 raised to n into n minus 1 by 2, which is equal to 2 raised to 3 into 3 minus 1 by 2, which is equal to 2 raised to 3 equal to 8. These 8 graphs are as shown below. For an n-node undirected simple graph, maximum number of edges is given by n into n minus 1 by 2, result when the graph is complete. For an n-node directed simple graph, maximum number of edges is given by n into n minus 1. In a pseudograph or multigraph, maximum number of edges possible is infinite due to the presence of parallel edges. Regular graph. If degree of all the vertices of a graph is same, say k, then the graph is said to be k-regular. All cycle graphs are 2-regular. All complete graph kn is n minus 1 regular. Regular graph.
A graph G is said to be regular if all its vertices have the same degree. In a graph, if the degree of each vertex is k, then the graph is called a k-regular graph. In both the graphs, all the vertices have degree 2. They are called 2-regular graphs. Complete graph. A simple graph with n mutual vertices is called a complete graph and it is denoted by kn. In the graph, a vertex should have edges with all other vertices, then it is called a complete graph. In both the graphs, each vertex in the graph is connected with all the remaining vertices in the graph except by itself. Cyclic graph. A graph with at least one cycle is called a cyclic graph. In this graph, we have two cycles, AB, CDA and CF, GEC. Hence, it is called a cyclic graph. Acyclic graph. A graph with no cycle is called a acyclic graph. In this graph, we do not have any cycles. Hence, it is a non-cyclic graph. Bipartite graph. In this graph, you can observe two sets of vertices, V1 and V2. Here, two edges named AE and BD are connecting the vertices of two sets V1 and V2. Complete bipartite graph. A bipartite graph G equal to V, E with partition V equal to V1, V2 is said to be a complete bipartite graph if every vertex in V1 is connected to every vertex of V2. In general, a complete bipartite graph connects each vertex from set V1 to each vertex from set V2. This graph is a complete bipartite graph because it has edges connecting each vertex from set V1 to each vertex from set V2. Chromatic number of a graph. The minimum number of colors required to proper color the graph is called its chromatic number. The term proper coloring means color the vertices of the given graph so that no two adjacent vertices have the same color. Chromatic number of some popular graphs are given in the table below. Graph chromatic number. Trees, the chromatic number is 2. Bipartite graph 2. Even length cycle graphs 2. Odd length cycle graphs 3. Complete graph on n vertices kn. Its chromatic number is n. Complete bipartite graph on n vertices. Its chromatic number is 2. Chromatic number less than or equal to 1 plus degree of any vertex of the graph. Chromatic number of planar graph is 4. Eulerian or Euler graph. A graph that contains an Euler circuit is known as an Eulerian graph. Euler circuit. A circuit in the graph that cover all the edges of the graph. Euler trial. A trial that cover all the edges of the graph. Then Hamiltonian graph. A graph that contains Hamiltonian cycle is known as Hamiltonian graph. Hamiltonian cycle. A cycle spans over all vertices of the graph. Again, Hamiltonian path. A path that covers all the vertices of the graph. A walk. Any sequence of vertices and edges of a graph. Repetition allowed. Repetition allowed in walk. Trial. A walk in which edges cannot repeat, where vertices can repeat. That is a trial. Path. A walk in which vertices cannot repeat, so edges too won't repeat. Edges in a path, edges and vertices won't repeat. Circuit. Closed trial is a circuit and closed path is a cycle. An undirected graph possesses an Eulerian circuit if and only if it is connected and its vertices are all of even degree. An undirected graph possesses an Eulerian trial if and only if it is connected and exactly two of its vertices are of odd degree and remaining vertices are of even degree. The Eulerian trial will always start from one vertex of odd degree and end with another vertex of odd degree. An easy way to find out Hamiltonian cycle and path is still an open problem. The trivial solution tries all possibilities. Hence, Euler circuit problem belongs to class P, where Hamiltonian cycle problem belongs to class NP. Cycle graph. A graph whose vertices are all connected each other forming a single cycle. Cycle graph with n vertices is denoted by Cn. C1 is a loop. C2 is a diagonal, a pair of parallel undirected edges in a multigraph, or a pair of anti-parallel edges in a digraph. C3 is called a triangle. Acyclic graph. Graph without any cycle is known as acyclic graph. Unicyclic graph. A graph with exactly one cycle. Panacyclic graph. Graph with every possible cycle of length from 3 to the order of the graph. Girth of a graph. Length of the shortest simple cycle of the graph. Circumference of graph. Length of the longest simple cycle of the graph. The girth and circumference of a cyclic graph are defined to be infinite. Connected graph. If there is a path between every pair of vertices of an undirected graph, then it is said to be connected, otherwise disconnected. Connected graph. A graph G is said to be connected if there exists a path between every pair of vertices. In this graph, each vertex has its own edge connected to other edge. Hence, it is a connected graph. Disconnected graph. A graph G is disconnected if it does not contain at least two connected vertices. In this disconnected graph, there are two components, one with ABCD vertices and another with EFGH vertices. The two components are independent and not connected to each other. Hence, it is called a disconnected graph. Weakly connected graph. In a directed graph, once we remove direction, if the underlying undirected graph is found to be connected, then the given directed graph is said to be weakly connected, strongly connected graph. In a directed graph, if there is a path between every pair of vertices, for a pair of vertices A, B, there should be path from A to B and B to A. Then the graph is called strongly connected. Connected component. Maximal connected subgraph of the given graph. DFS or BFS can be used to find out all the connected components of a graph. Strongly connected components find out using DFS. Articulation point. It is a vertex in the graph whose removal disconnects the graph. While removing a vertex, also remove all edges incident on it. Bridge. It is an edge of the graph whose removal disconnects the graph. While removing an edge, remove only that edge. Don't remove even its end vertices. Biconnected graph. A graph without any articulation point or bridge. Biconnected components. The maximal biconnected subgraph of the given graph is said to be its biconnected component, identified using DFS. Example. In the given graph, articulation points are A, H, I. Bridge is A, H, H, I, I, N. Biconnected components are A, B, C, D, A, H, H, K, M, H, I, I, N. Vertex cut or vertex connectivity. Set of vertices whose removal disconnects the graph. Articulation point, if any, alone form a vertex cut. Edge cut or edge connectivity. Set of edges whose removal disconnects the graph. Bridge, if any, alone forms an edge cut. Vertex cover. Set of vertices that cover all edges of the given graph. A vertex cover of an undirected graph G of V, I is defined formally as a subset V1, subset of V, vertices such that if UV belongs to E, then U belongs to V1 or V belongs to V1. Minimum vertex cover. Vertex cover of minimum cardinality. The problem of finding minimum vertex cover of a graph belongs to class NP. Edge cover. Set of edges that cover all edges of the given graph, that is, all the vertices of the given graph, should be there as the end vertex of some edge in the set of edges
forming the edge cover of the graph.
Independent set. Set of vertices of the having no common edge between them. That is, set of mutually non-adjacent vertices of the graph, mutual enemies. Max independent. Independent set of maximum cardinality. The problem of finding maximum independent set of a graph belongs to class NP. Matching. Set of edges having no common vertex between them. Perfect matching. Matching that spans over all the vertices of the graph. Click. Complete subgraph of the given graph. That is, set of mutually adjacent vertices of the given graph. Set of mutual friends of vertices. Max click. Click of maximum cardinality. That is, maximal complete subgraph of the given graph. Finding max click also belongs to class NP. For example, consider the following graph. Here, minimum vertex cover equal to set ADHIN. Maximum independent set equal to BCM. Max click equal to IMNH. Perfect matching equal to set BD, AC, HI, MN. Tree. An acyclic connected graph is a tree. Let G be a graph with N vertices and M edges. The following statements are equivalent. All statements are applicable for a tree. G is a tree. G is minimally connected. G is a connected acyclic graph. G is connected and N equal to E plus 1. Every two nodes of G are joined by a unique path. G is acyclic, and if any two adjacent vertices are joined by an edge, the resulting graph has exactly one cycle. Spanning tree. A tree that spans over all the vertices of the given graph. Cayley's theorem. In a complete graph of n vertices, it is possible to have at most n raised to n minus 2 spanning trees. That is, the maximum number of spanning tree possible using n vertices is n raised to n minus 2. Forest. Collection of trees. Acyclic graph, connected or disconnected. Bipartite graph. If the vertex of a given graph can be partitioned into two sets such that all the edges lie between the two partitions and will not lie within a partition. Bipartite graphs. Vertices are partitioned into those shared by black and white. Complete bipartite graph. In bipartite graph, if between the two partitions there is an edge between every pair of vertices, in a particular pair of vertices, one vertex should be taken from one partition and another vertex should be taken from other partition. The graph is said to be complete bipartite. A complete bipartite graph with m vertices on one partition and n vertices on another partition is denoted by KMN. This is a graph of complete bipartite graph K34. Number of edges in KMN equal to M into N. K1N is called a star. All complete bipartite graphs which are trees are stars. K13 is called a claw. Claw-free graph. A graph that does not have a claw as an induced subgraph, K33, is called the utility graph. Biregular graph. A bipartite graph in which all vertices on the same side of the partition have the same degree. Complete bipartite graphs are biregular. Complete bipartite graph KMN becomes regular when M equal to N. All trees are bipartite. All even length cycles are bipartite, but odd length cycles are not bipartite. Bipartiteness checking. A graph is bipartite if and only if it contains no odd length cycle. Bipartiteness checking belongs to class P, as it can be done using BFS or DFS. A bipartite graph is said to be balanced if and only if both the partitions contain equal number of vertices.
Star graph. A complete bipartite graph of the form K1 n minus 1 is a star graph with n vertices. A star graph is a complete bipartite graph if a single vertex belongs to one set and all the remaining vertices belongs to the other set. In the above graph, out of n vertices, all the n minus 1 vertices are connected to a single vertex. Hence, it is in the form of K1 n minus 1, which are star graphs. Distance between two vertices. If there are multiple paths connecting two vertices, then the shortest path is considered as the distance between the two vertices d of u, v. Example, take a look at the following graph. Here, the distance from vertex D to vertex E, or simply DE, is 1. As there is one edge between them, there are many paths from vertex D to vertex E. They are DA, AB, BE, DF, FG, GE, DF, FC, CA, AB, BE, DA, AC, CF, FG, GE. Eccentricity of a vertex. The maximum distance between a vertex to all other vertices is considered as the eccentricity of vertex E of V. The eccentricity of A is 3. The distance from A to B is 1, AB, A to C is 1, AC, A to D is 1, AD, A to E is 2, AB, BE or ADDE, A to F is 2, AC, CF or ADDF. A to G is 3, AC, CF, FG or ADDF, FG. So, the eccentricity is 3, which is a maximum from vertex A from the distance between AG, which is maximum. Radius of a connected graph. From all the eccentricities of the vertices in a graph, the radius of the connected graph R of G is the minimum of all those eccentricities. The eccentricity of A is 3, E of B equal to 3, E of C equal to 3, E of D equal to 2, E of E equal to 3, E of F equal to 3, E of G equal to 3. In the above graph, R of G equal to 2, which is the minimum eccentricity of D. Diameter of a graph. From all the eccentricities of the vertices in a graph, the diameter of the connected graph D of G is the maximum of all those eccentricities. The eccentricity of A is 3. The eccentricity of B equal to 3, E of C equal to 3, E of D equal to 2, E of E equal to 3, E of F equal to 3, E of G equal to 3. In the above graph, D of G equal to 3, which is the maximum eccentricity. Central point. If the eccentricity of a graph is equal to its radius, then it is known as the central point of the graph. If E of V equal to R of V, then V is the central point of the graph G. E of A equal to 3, E of B equal to 3, E of C equal to 3, E of D equal to 2, E of E equal to 3, E of F equal to 3, E of G equal to 3. In the example graph, D is the central point of the graph, E of D equal to R of D, which is equal to 2. Center. The set of all central points of G is called the center of the graph. In the example graph, D is the center of the graph. Circumference. The number of edges in the longest cycle of G is called the circumference of G. In the example graph, the circumference is 6, which we derived from the longest cycle ACFG EBA or ACFD EBA. Girth. The number of edges in the shortest cycle of G is called its girth. In the example graph, the girth of the graph is 4, which we derived from the shortest cycle ACFDA or DFGED or ABEDA. Distance or geodesic distance between two vertices of a graph. Number of edges in the shortest path connecting them. If there is no path connecting two vertices, then distance is infinite. Eccentricity E of V of a vertex V is the greatest geodesic distance between V and any other vertices in the graph. Radius of a graph. Minimum eccentricity of any vertex of the graph. Diameter of a graph. Maximum eccentricity of any vertex of the graph. Center of a graph. Collection of vertices whose eccentricity is least. A vertex whose eccentricity equals radius of the graph.
Center vertex. A vertex whose eccentricity equals diameter of the graph. Peripheral vertex. In the given graph, radius equal to 3, diameter equal to 5, center nodes equal to BDE, peripheral vertices H, G. Fundamental numbers of a graph. Number of vertices of the graph, say N. Number of edges of the graph, say M. Number of components of the graph, say C.
Fundamental numbers are related by the following statements. N greater than or equal to C always. N equal to C for a null graph, which is a trivial case. M greater than or equal to N minus C. M equal to N minus C for a spanning forest of C trees, which is also a trivial case. When C equal to 1, M greater than or equal to N minus 1 for a connected graph with one component. M equal to N minus 1 satisfied for a spanning tree, which is a trivial case. Rank of the graph equal to N minus C. Nullity of the graph equal to M minus N plus C. Planar graph. A planar graph is a graph which can be drawn in the plane without any edge crossing. Some pictures of a planar graph might have crossing edges, but it's possible to redraw the picture to eliminate the crossings. For example, although the usual pictures of K4 and Q3 have crossing edges, it's easy to redraw them without any crossing edges as shown below. Coloring planar graphs. One application of planar graphs involves coloring maps of countries. Two countries sharing a border must be given different colors. We can turn this into a graph coloring problem by assigning a graph node to each country. We then connect two nodes with an edge exactly when their regions share a border. This graph is called the dual of our original map. Because the map are planar, these dual graphs are always planar. That's it for this video lecture. Do subscribe to this channel in order to get notified when I am posting a new video. Thank you.